In this video, you are going to learn which are the food combinations that are a must to avoid, how we have to combine protein, vegetables, fats, fruits in order to have optimal health, which is the best and the worst way to do it. So welcome. And before we get started, I'm Dr. Lena Maganto. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, I'm really pleased to have you here, to bring you a weekly information to improve your health. So remember to be sure that you subscribe to the channel and click the bell button to get the weekly notifications. You don't miss anything. This is a community space where you are also able to ask any question that you may have about the topic that we are talking about today or anything else. So welcome. And then today we are talking about food combination. Food combination is as important or even more as the food that we put on our plate. So to understand why food combination is important, the key for optimal health is good digestion. We really need to focus always on good digestion. The digestive system is the second brain of the body. It goes from your mouth all the way down to your anus. It's almost your entire body, and a lot of things can happen in there. And good digestion is not as easy as it looks like. So we really need to focus on proper digestion. And one of the things that helps with that is how we combine food. What happens when we don't digest the food properly is that we don't break down the food. The food is going to be fermented by the yeast like candida or the bacteria in your gut, and it's going to cause toxin buildup. All those toxins end up going to your liver. So you can end up with liver toxicity, but you end up with yeast overgrowth, with candida overgrowth. You may end up with histamine intolerance as well, with SIBO, and all that toxin accumulation end up being translated in oxidative stress and inflammation. That inflammation causes leaky gut. When goes through your gut barrier, can affect every single tissue of your body, your joints, your skin, can go to your brain. You can end up with autoimmune conditions, Hashimoto's, Graves, with fatigue, with feeling bloated, heartburn, reflux, joint inflammation, having weight loss resistance. How you combine food can be involved in how well you are absorbing food and in weight loss resistance if it's related to inflammation. So when we combine food in the process of healing, our gut can help us in improving all those conditions that I just mentioned before and on improving your optimal health. So it's why this is a very important thing that I consider that you should print and put in your refrigerator. So I'm gonna put a link in the description of the video so you can download this chart for food combination. I'm going to try to make it very simple. I'm not going to go really deep into it, but this is a very important topic. So based on food combination, imagine our gut is designed to digest one type of food at a time, just one. However, when we prepare a meal, we want to make it interesting, right? We want to see a lot of colors and as many different type of foods as possible, so we feel that is more interesting. But actually, the more type of different foods we try to put on our plate, the more difficult is going to be the digestion. So it's gonna end up with toxin buildup and inflammation. So the simplest we can see our plate, the better. And that is how we have to try to do every single of our meals: breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, the simplest, the better. So which are the two things that we have to consider when we talk about food combination? One is that the speed. Not all the foods are broken down and digested at the same speed. Some foods are broken down faster and digested faster than others. So if you put a certain ingredient, certain food that is has a slower digestion than another one, that you put it together with another one that is digesting really fast, what is going to happen is that the whole process is going to slow down and the food is going to get stuck and it's going to cause a traffic jam in your intestine, in your digestive system. So speed is one of the important things to consider. And the second one is digestive enzymes and pH, both of them, because certain foods need some digestive enzymes. Other food needs different type of digestive enzymes. The more type of food you try to put at the same time, the more type of digestive enzymes you need. And the pH, because some foods require a more alkaline pH than other foods that are digested better whenever there is an acidic pH. So the pH, the digestive enzymes, and how fast we are breaking down the food are the key components when we are thinking about food combination. So which are the things that we have to avoid and which is the best way to combine? And as I said, I'm going to try to make it very simple. This is always focus on an anti-inflammatory diet, on preventing inflammation, preventing any related disorder, any disorder related to inflammation. So let's start with fruits. Because we hear fruits are really good for you, they are really rich in vitamin minerals. That's true, but not always fruits are made equal based on the amount of sugars, carbohydrates, or if you have any problem like candida overgrowth, histamine, or SIBO, small intestine bacteria overgrowth, the type of fruits that we eat or if you have to slow down in fruits is important. But when we talk about food combination, the best way we digest foods is by itself, because fruits are formed by simple sugars and they are broken down really fast. So you combine fruits with other foods that require a slow process, then is when the problems are coming. It's going to get fermented. You may feel bloated and blenching after meals. So desserts, fruits after a meal is a big mistake. You already ate enough carbohydrates, enough food with your meal, so you don't need to put any extra fruits after meal. They are going to get fermented. So fruits, ideally, you want to eat them by themselves, separate from other meals, at least 3 hours. That is what is important, alone, on empty stomach, alone. Then let's talk about starchy food. And when I talk about starchy food, is any type of grain or grain-based foods. If you are eating pasta, breads, even whole grain breads, any grains, any high starchy vegetables, like for example, pumpkin, squash, butternut squash, corn, all that group of high starchy foods. So ideally, high starchy foods are better digested in an alkaline environment. So they are better digested with other foods that also digest better with alkalinity, which means protein and high starchy foods shouldn't be together. So that is moving on to the next group, which is protein. Protein needs an acidic environment to be digested compared to the high starchy foods that they need an alkaline environment. And we said that when we put acidic foods with alkaline foods, becomes neutral and you may have a hard time digesting all of them at the same time. So protein, and when I talk about protein, is animal protein or even plant-based protein. So animal protein like chicken, eggs, any type of meat, fish, or plant-based protein, we are talking about beans, nuts, seeds as well. So proteins are better digested in an acidic environment and they cause acidity. And they are digested slowly. And high starchy foods, they are digested a little bit faster and on alkalinity. So they should never be combined together. And then we go to fat. And when we talk about fat, it's if we are eating avocado or we are eating coconut oil, olive oil, the fats, the heavy fats. So fats, ideally, they combine better with vegetables and high starchy foods than with protein. So protein with high starchy foods and heavy fats are not doing very well. So the summary, the easy way to see it is fruits by itself, and then non-starchy vegetables. This is the main group that I always say, focus the most on non-starchy vegetables. Non-starchy vegetables like all the green leafies, cucumber, the cruciferous vegetables like broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, if you are doing good with those type of vegetables. So low starchy vegetables should be the main thing that you see always on your plate. 50 to 75% of your plate should be low starchy vegetables. And that group can be combined with protein, animal protein or plant-based protein, and or high starchy vegetables, which is high starchy vegetables or high starchy grain-based foods. But these three groups, protein, grains, and high starchy vegetables, should never be combined together because that is complicating your digestions too much. This group has different type of pH, has different speeds to be digested, so better, and needs different type of digestive enzymes. So these groups should never be combined together if you want to have an easy digestion. However, this group can be combined with any of them, and low starchy vegetables are really rich in digestive enzymes by itself. That is a really rich group, rich in digestive enzymes with help in the digestion of each of these groups. So it's why the main food you want to see on your plate, low starchy vegetables, and combined with protein or grain or starchy vegetables. And then fat can be combined with this group always, even avocado, but ideally never with heavy proteins, and could be combined with some of the starchy foods and fruits by itself. Okay, so as you can see, I wanted to keep it simple. I didn't want to go too deep. I'm going to put also in the comments of the video, in the description, that when we talk about fruits, for example, something that is important to identify is if the fruits are in the groups of the acidic fruits, like for example, some berries or oranges, or is a sweet fruit, or is a sub-acidic fruit. Because sub-acidic fruit, like for example, apples, can be combined with, sweet or acidic fruits. But ideally, acidic and sweet fruits, because of the pH, shouldn't be combined together. So I'm gonna put the list of which are sub-acidic fruits, which are sweet fruits, or which are the acidic fruits. So remember, sweet and acidic, the two extremes, should never be combined together. But the sub, you can combine with one or the other. But always I say moderation. Too much fruit can also raise your insulin levels too much, spike your insulin when you are eating it by itself. So depending if you have diabetes or any other health concern, these basics for food combination should always be altered a little bit. So if we will work together, when you work with a healthcare practitioner, also the food combination is going to be modified based on if you are going through high cholesterol, diabetes, if you have really, really SIBO, for example, small intestine bacteria overgrowth. But this is the basic. Remember, 50 to 75% of your plate, low starchy vegetables, which can be combined with any food, and they give digestive enzymes to the meal to be able to digest any of these foods, protein or grains or high starchy vegetables, but these three groups should never be combined together because of the pH, the speed that they are broken down, and the digestive enzymes. All right, so give it a try. Give it a try because you will see, even if it looks too simple, your plate, you will see how your digestions are going to improve much more. And if you are playing with food combination already, I would love to hear in the comments or now how do you feel with it, how you are doing your combinations, which ones you feel better or not, but give it a try. And I will go through all the comments as well if you are watching the recording of this video to answer any question that you may have. Always remember, subscribe, clicking the subscribe button, the bell button, so you can get the weekly notification and ask your questions here as well. So I want to see if any of you now have any questions. Just put it in there in the comments. I'm so happy to see you here. Hola, hola. And now that you say hola, actually, that is why in Spain we are famous because we take naps, right? We say we always take a nap after lunch, which is not true. We work like everybody else. We don't always take a nap, but it's true that we are famous because we tend to take a nap. But also, why a person tends to take a nap after a meal is because of how you are combining the food. If you put too many ingredients on that plate that are going to be really difficult to digest, at the end it gets fermented and we get sluggish. You need a lot of energy to digest that meal. So you are going to get sluggish, and it's why you need a nap. So the simplest, the better. And a lot of people tell me after we start working with food combination that they don't need to take a nap anymore, that they don't get the energy crash after a meal that they usually get, because you are going to be able to break down the food to absorb all the nutrients, and that's going to be transformed into energy for your body. So a lot of things can improve when we work with food combination. Wednesday, I will try to keep in mind to eat fruit on their own. That's important. Very helpful info. Food pairing. This is so important. It's as important as what we put on our mouth. So I will give the information so you can print out this chart, put it in your refrigerator, so you will always able to see it. Marta, Jan, so happy to see you here. Cindy. So Marta say, is it true that it is better to avoid high sweet fruits like mango and bananas? This is a totally different topic. Food combination, I didn't go deep into low carb or no low carb. I went through the groups that we have to pay attention how we combine whenever you see your meal. However, if you have diabetes, if you have high cholesterol, if you have bacteria or yeast overgrowth, bananas and mangoes are really, really high in sugar. If you live on a low-carb diet, they are really, really high in sugar. They are going to spike your insulin levels, your glucose levels. It's going to be transformed into triglycerides and cholesterol. It's feeding the bacteria and the yeast. Sugar feeds the microbes in our gut, and that causes more bacteria and yeast overgrowth and more inflammation. So that is why the food combination has to be modified a little bit also based on whatever the person goes through. That is why working with a healthcare practitioner one-to-one helps as well in that process. And in the description of the video, you can also find a link to book a free consultation with me so we could go deeper if you have something to work on as well. But that is a really good question. Sweet fruits are really high in sugar. So depending on what you go through, that is the ones that you have to eliminate or not. But also that is why you have to eat them by itself, because fruits are high in sugar and they are broken down really fast. So you don't want to combine them with any food that has a slow digestion, like, for example, plant-based protein or animal protein. Good question. Any other question, everyone? I'm so glad to see you here. Remember, if you have any extra questions, put them in the comments or shoot me an email. And I can also talk about that topic in the next Q&A every single week.